Crepey skin under eyes with bags. Can this be fixed without blepharoplasty? I am 30 years old, but my eyes look 50 plus. When I do not smile, my eyes look puffy underneath, as if I have a sinus infection, but I do not. When I do smile, the skin underneath my eyes becomes crepey. I look like a Sharpei. I feel like I am too young to get a blepharoplasty. However, if that is the real solution, I will get it. I just don't want to spend lots of money on different fillers, lasers, and whatnot, only to find out that I really should have just gotten the blef to begin with. Any advice?
Thank you for your question. You state in your question that you're 30 years old, but your eyes look like you're over 50. And you describe in very nice detail the presence of puffiness when you're not smiling, the presence of wrinkled skin, and that looks crepey, comparable to a Sharpei when you're smiling, and you're asking, can this area be improved without surgery? And so it's certainly a very reasonable position to be in, that you feel like at the age of 30 that the eyes are disproportionately looking aged compared to your chronological age. So I'm going to share with you our approach in our practice when we meet people like yourself. And as a cosmetic oculofacial plastic surgeon specializing in cosmetic surgery of the eyes for over 20 years in Manhattan and Long Island, I have dealt with the entire spectrum of ages and situations that I can give you a lot of perspective to help you make an intelligent decision. So with that being said, when someone like yourself comes to us, we first start with the history. We have to ask ourselves, what are the factors that are causing the eyes to look disproportionately older than your age? A lot of times, there are two factors that probably dominate the history that accelerates aging. One is smoking. People who smoke do a tremendous amount of harm to not only their physical body, their organs, their heart, their lungs, but in addition, they accelerate the aging of the skin. The eyelid skin is the thinnest skin in the body, and it is subject to stress. It's very sensitive to stress. And so imagine with smoking, the carbon monoxide, which starves the cells of oxygen, and combined with the generation of free radicals, it is really damaging to the skin. The second part is sun exposure. Sun exposure causes something called photoaging. It accelerates the aging process, and several studies have been done comparing people who live on the West Coast and the East Coast, and the certain studies involved in twins. And even when the West Coast individual is very good about sunblock and being smart about avoiding excess sun exposure, incidental sun exposure makes them always look a lot older than their East Coast counterpart. So those are two environmental factors that you need to think about. If you're a sun worshiper, you go to tanning salons, you need to stop that or reduce that. If you're a smoker, you need to stop altogether. There's not a doctor in the world who'll say, don't, you know, continue smoking. A lot of times you have to cut it down or switch to some type of an alternative, such as a nicotine patch or gum or even something, a drug like Chantix. But then we look at also ethnic background. It is well established that people with what's called Fitzpatrick Type 1 skin, this is typically a light-skinned Irish person, someone with light hair, blue eyes, light skin, will photo-age, or will the skin will age faster than, let's say, Fitzpatrick Type 5, someone of African descent who has thicker skin and pigment. So this could be a combination in the same line as ethnicity as genetics. Does this trait appear to run in your family? So once we've established that, it's definitely important to not label a particular time that is always right to do a cosmetic surgical procedure. It's not about timing, it's really about when you have a particular issue that needs to be addressed. So at the age of 30, I can tell you we have done blepharoplasty, lower eyelid surgery, on people considerably younger than you. We have had many patients in their 20s, and our youngest patient we ever treated for lower eyelid bags or under eye bags was 14 years old. And this is a young man who was being teased at school because everyone was saying he was on drugs. And so it's not, again, it's more about when you have the problem that you do something about it rather than waiting for a particular age milestone. So in your situation, we would address two issues. One is the puffiness. Now the puffiness under the eyes is caused by something called lower eyelid fat prolapse. Lower eyelid fat prolapse means that the fat that's normally around your eyes pushes forward, creates a bulge, and makes your eyes look puffy. When you smile, you activate a muscle called the orbicularis muscle, and it has a tendency to push those fat pockets back. So certainly they may not be significant when you're smiling, but unless you're smiling all day long, continuously, when people see you, they're going to see the puffy under eye bags and wonder why you're so tired. So when with someone who's relatively young like yourself, we typically do a procedure called a transconjunctival blepharoplasty. Transconjunctival blepharoplasty is a method of approaching the fat pockets and resecting, sculpting, repositioning, whatever is necessary from the inside of the eyelid. This way you avoid an external scar. That being addressed, we also address the quality of the skin. Why? What makes the skin so quality challenging? Well, it's the thinnest, it's the crepiness. It is half a millimeter in thickness. So we do a dual approach to the improvement of skin quality. One is we use thermal device called fractional CO2 laser. Now fractional CO2 laser is essentially using fractionated laser energy, which means that this is done in several dots with small spaces in between, to generate finely placed thermal energy to resurface to a degree the external skin, as well as to deliver energy into the dermis or the backbone of the skin to cause contraction. In addition, we use something called platelet-rich plasma. This is derived from your own blood, and it's been a remarkable benefit in synergy with the CO2 laser. What this does is it generates collagen. It's based on a wound healing model, where if you get a cut, your body generates collagen to fix that area and to create new skin, or repair the skin. So the idea is that with doing platelet-rich plasma, we're getting a stem cell-based response that helps improve the quality of the skin and the color, and we really get very, very nice results. In patients who don't have bags, we often actually combine it with a filler to even treat tear troughs or hollows. So the combination of transconjunctival blepharoplasty, fractional CO2 laser, and PRP is very, very much routine for us, and we've had really nice results this way. I think it's important to do surgical procedures when they're indicated. A lot of times people are afraid of doing surgery, and they may have the concern that they're too young or they're just afraid of surgery. And the reality is that in our practice, the way we do things, we have our own facilities within our offices. We're Joint Commission approved facilities, same people who certify hospitals. What we've done in our office is create a facility where we maintain the high standards set by the Joint Commission, the organization that certifies hospitals and surgery centers, but at the same time within an office setting, it's much more personalized, and the people that you see are the ones who are the people you know, and it's less impersonal than a hospital and surgery center type environment. Plus, we do our procedures under local anesthesia with light sedation. There have been many times that people have said that they've had less swelling and bruising a week after lower eyelid surgery than they've had getting injectables. And there is a lot of truth to that because of the process that we've developed over the years, we're able to get people looking good pretty fast. So, and from my perspective, you really do have something that requires more definitive procedures. Now, it doesn't mean that we want to negate other things such as topicals like retinols and other skin maintenance procedures, but I would avoid the non-surgical solutions because I just don't think they'll be adequate to address your concerns. So I would advise you meet with qualified, experienced cosmetic surgeons who perform a lot of lower eyelid surgery and get a sense of whether or not you're comfortable with them and move forward with a more definitive plan. The benefits of lower eyelid surgery are quite long-lasting. Again, I've been practicing for 20 years and I've been very impressed by how good patients look for so long. Their bags don't come back necessarily, and their eyes hold up very, very well. Again, it depends on the age. If you do a procedure like this when you're 30, it will hold up for many years. So I hope that was helpful. I wish you the best of luck. Thank you for your question.